Today we're going to do the 10 art style challenge, and this is how the challenge works. You draw a drawing in your style and redraw the drawing in 9 different art styles. Let's do that now. I'm going to be doing this entire challenge on my iPad Pro. I'm usually a traditional guy. I do, you know, a lot of drawings on the traditional medium, but for the sake of convenience and speed, I'm going to be doing this challenge on my iPad. Let's begin this thing. Okay, the first style, which was obviously my style, that's the one I started out with. And I have to say, before I did this challenge, I thought my style was fairly simplistic. I thought it was the most simplistic style that is out there, but man, I was wrong. More on that later. Anyways, my style is sort of blobby. That's how I mentioned my style. You know, it's called the blobby style. You know, it's blobby, it's full of blobbiness, and it's full of blobs. I don't know how you describe it, but that's my style. You know what? Let's go ahead and name it the Kesh style. Anyways, I came up with a dumb pose, like when I was holding the peace sign, it was like the world's dumbest pose, but because I needed some pose to establish a baseline so that I can actually base all the other 9 styles out of this one drawing. So that's what I did. No, that was the first drawing. The second style was from one of my favorite modern cartoons ever, and that was Gravity Falls. Gravity Falls is probably one of my favorite modern cartoons that is out there. I have great memories watching that show. It was just a year back, to be honest. But anyways, I have good memories of that show. I love that show. And that style is what I call the iconic style, you know? So when you look at things like Disney and things like that, they have more of a dynamic style, you know? Iconic styles, on the other hand, are more simple. Symmetrical. They are more rigid, they are more structured, they are more clear, they have more clarity, and that's what I love about the style. And once I just did this drawing, I realized my first illustration in my style, which I thought was the most simplistic drawing that you can do, seemed complex. Then I realized, man, this is why these cartoons probably work, because they have more simplicity and more clarity in their drawings. And anyways, yeah, that was my second style. It was Gravity Falls. Third style was based on Simpsons. By the way, fun fact, I've never watched that show before. I've watched one or two episodes here and there, and I've watched parts of the movie Simpsons. I don't know which one. I think they have a lot of those Simpsons movies out there. Anyways, I watched a part of those things. I really love the show, love the episodes which I did watch, and I think I should probably, you know, go ahead and start watching Simpsons. I heard it's like a good show. So I based my character, my illustration, right, based on a character named Bart Simpson from the show. And one of the coolest stylistic elements which I noticed was, apart from the cool yellow skin, which I absolutely love, actually that thing makes the whole drawing stand out from the other drawings. And apart from that particular element, another element which I noticed and which I never used before was the uniform line weight. I am a guy who uses thicks and thin lines for my line weights in my illustrations and in my drawings, but this was the first time ever in a very long time since I was a little kid where I was forced to use a uniform line weight, which gave a really, really cool effect, which I really liked. And it's something that I'd probably take away with me and apply it, right, in my future drawings. So that's something cool. And this whole drawing made me really laugh. And also, I attached the hair, right, to the face, like the character Bart Simpson, because, you know, I didn't want to draw a separate hair. I just wanted to be one huge shape. And that's what I did for this little character. And the next style was Death Note. Yes, an anime style, an anime-ish mixed with American cartoonish elements to it. Death Note, by the way, is an anime. Probably one of my favorite animes ever, along with Attack on Titans and a couple of other animes out there. I don't watch a lot of animes, but those two animes are probably close and near and dear to my heart, because, you know, I freaking love the pacing, the story, everything about that show. And I loved how the characters look, because it wasn't a classic anime with too big of an eyes. It was like good, realistic, humanistic thing to it. And it was really fun to watch that show and to experience that style visually. But to draw it, it was boring. I didn't like this. I didn't like this thing at all. It was like so bland, and it didn't feel, it was so normal. Like everybody does this thing. I was like, man, why am I even doing this thing? So that's another learning from doing this challenge. I don't want to draw the humans the way they look like. That's the learning right there. So I'm going to use that learning moving on. So definitely the least favorite drawing of mine in this thing. And for some reason, I look like a kid right there. I don't know why I drew myself like a kid. Like, I look like a kid. The next one was a cartoon from the 90s, Ed, and Eddie. For those people who haven't watched this cartoon, I would highly, highly, highly recommend that you go and watch it. It's a great cartoon. It's like the cartoon, it's like the way the cartoons are supposed to be. The cartoons these days, yeah, I have a very bad relationship with cartoons that are being produced these days. They're not cartoons, they're like virtue signaling propaganda machines aimed to sort of brainwash the minds of kids. Cartoons back those days were fun. It was fun, it was good. It's like, you can laugh at it, right? You can't do that these days. I don't know, maybe I'm an old man, I don't know, maybe. Anyways, the one of the coolest elements that I've noticed in the show Ed and Eddie was their moving lines. You know, there was one of the very few cartoons that had that jittery line effect where the lines kept moving. So it always gave a sense of dynamic flow and movement to the characters, even when they were sort of standing still. So I incorporated that into my drawing. And also the very, very rude representation of drawing the characters itself is another thing that I sort of took away from this. You just don't have to be too serious about the way you draw your cartoons or your characters. You know, what I learned from looking at that show was you can just be more casual. You draw your eye right here, you draw another eye right here. As long as you draw those eyes, it's cool enough, right? That's what I like about this thing. It's more abstractual representation of the way you draw things. And yeah, I really love this thing. One of my favorites from this challenge, the Ed, and Eddie one. So yeah, for some reason, all the characters I designed sort of looks like the main character that I'm sort of studying from. Very normal. I don't have too much time to study and learn about these characters. So yeah, anyways, I'm very happy with the way it turned out. The sixth style which I tried to emulate was Peanuts. I haven't watched or read the comics before. I think there's a cartoon series, I'm not sure, but Peanuts is a comic strip on the newspapers back in the old days. Apparently it was the first one, you know, way before even like Calvin and Hobbes. It's like a classic legendary thing from what I've observed. I haven't read those comics a lot, but what I did do was watch the movie Peanuts, which I absolutely loved. One of those few movies out there, right, which shows the realities of being a kid and being a child, right? Man, after that movie, it's like, man, I forgot how to be a kid. Probably I should, you know, train that part. Right? If you haven't watched that movie, go watch that thing. The penis style is very simplistic, and also recognize that it's very close to the way I actually draw things. It was very fun to sort of realize that even though I haven't watched or seen this sort of style before or grown up with it, I've developed a style that is very close to it. You know, sort of also on the blobbier side of things, very fat, very full of form and mass, which was nice, you know? So yeah, that's Peanuts. The next one was Dexter's Laboratory. Another classic cartoon from the 90s. Let's hold here for a second, all right? This cartoon right here, Dexter's Lab, my favorite cartoon ever. Probably ever, yeah. I used to love this show so much when I was a kid. I built like a mini lab inside my closet. I used to pretend to go in there like it's like a secret lab and do scientific experiments, build my own robots and stuff like that. Man, good old days, I'm telling you. One of the coolest things about Dexter's Lab is that they actually take all the characters and put it into one little shape. The main character Dexter here, right here, right? He's pretty much a box, right? The entire character fits into a box. His sister Dee Dee sort of fits into this big lanky stick, a lollipop type deal. Another character sort of also looks like a big lollipop. That's one of the coolest design elements of the show. And also very, very thick outlines, which I really love. I don't like thin outlines. Like for some reason, I don't. I just don't like them. But thick outlines then. Good clarity shapes or clear shapes, right? So what I did was I tried to fit my own character sort of into a little box, and I couldn't lose the glasses because, you know, glasses was the biggest element of that character Dexter, so I couldn't lose it, so I just kept it and sort of looked like a twin brother of Dexter, like the third brother who they never wanted. The next style which I went for was Dragon Ball Z. I was really expecting to try out this style, to be honest. So I tried out the style, and again, another thing which was really fun to watch and experience, wasn't fun to draw. It again seemed too typical, and I didn't like the Dragon Ball Z style. It was really great show. It's a great show. Probably defined or redefined the way fighting styles were, you know, meant to be in cartoons or animes and things like that. They did a really good job with the fighting and all the, even though the fights lasted like 15 episodes, right? But anyways, yeah, it was a great show. It was a great show. Fun to watch. It wasn't fun to draw. I didn't expect that from Death Note and this Dragon Ball Z style. I don't know. It was very disappointing. To the eighth one, the eighth style was the Powerpuff Girls. Yes, I grew up watching Powerpuff Girls. In fact, I drew a lot of Powerpuff Girls when I was a kid, right? I used to, you know, back then there weren't any DVD players, at least at my place. And I, you know, like watched the TV. Once that frame that I wanted to draw came, I need to like be very, very attentive, like make sure and make a quick note of that frame. Then I go back into my sketchbook. That frame goes away, right? The show's over, you go away, then you take your sketchbook and you draw. So it was a great show, and I think they revamped it. I don't think it's good. I saw an episode of the revamped version. It's like, what are they doing? They're 21st centurying everything. I don't like it. Anyways, the Powerpuff Girls is obviously very simplistic, very big, round face, one little shape for the body. I base my design on the rowdy, rough boys. Characters from the Powerpuff Girls, and you know, I sort of based my shoes, the whole attire based on that, and pretty much added my own style and the color to it. And yeah, it's a good drawing. It was fun. It's not that revolutionary. The last one, the last but not least, the style which I explored was Rick and Morty. So Rick and Morty, right? Another example of the iconic style where everything is symmetrical, everything is more clear, everything is more, you know, it's all based on fluid shapes. Instead of basing your drawings based on anatomy and realistic things, you take inspiration from that. But what you do is take those things, simplify those things down to like simple forms and simple shapes. And that's, you know, what the style of Rick and Morty represents for me. And I have to say, among all the 10 styles which I did, Rick and Morty and The Simpsons were my absolute favorite, and Ed, Edd n Eddy, right? These three things made me realize, okay, these are some of the things that I can actually take into my drawing and apply it. And I thought, why my drawings were simplistic. I want to keep things simple because I want to focus more on story rather than the drawings. So that's Rick and Morty. You know, it's Rick and Morty. So yeah, that's the 10 art style challenge for you. I had an absolute blast doing this challenge. For some reason, I stay away from the trends, try not to do these challenges, but whenever I do these things, man, it's a breakthrough. Maybe I should do more challenges. Next time I'm gonna do something like a customizing challenge. I'm gonna do that, right? So yeah, I had so much fun making this. Learned so much, which was very unexpected. So yeah, great stuff, great challenge. You have fun doing this thing. So cool. That's the episode. Bye bye. Pa! I was trying to aim for the lens. It didn't work out. Anyways.